what's up everybody, it's Amaya. So today's tutorial is going to be a super exciting one, and it is a homecoming tutorial. I'm going to say a little something. I am homeschooled. I can't go to homecoming, except if I'm asked by somebody. And I was asked by my best friend Zach to go to a homecoming, and I am so excited, and it's going to be my first homecoming. I'm in 10th grade, but it's going to be my first homecoming. I'm excited. I'm like so excited to go. I've heard it's not like that exciting, but just to be able to go to homecoming and put on a pretty dress and put on makeup and all that sorts of stuff is going to be exciting. This tutorial is going to be using all drugstore products, and it's going to be featuring this drugstore product, and this is the L'Oreal Infallible Eyeshadow in Bronzed Taupe. This is what it looks like in the pot. It is just super gorgeous, kind of gunmetal-y, but yet it still has that bronze glow to it. Here's what it looks like swatched on my arm. As you can see, again, just super beautiful and super pigmented. My lighting changed. If you guys like this look and you want to see how to get it, just keep watching. So I'm going to be starting out with my face today because I am doing a very smoky, soft look. I don't want anything too sharp because I feel like that'll make it look too, like, I don't know, sharp. I don't want something too sharp. I want something a little bit more soft. So I'm going to be starting out with my foundation today. If I did my foundation last, I'd get a sharp line, which is great, except I don't want that today. But depending on what you're going to do for your homecoming look, you can do foundation first or foundation last. Doesn't really matter. So, very important step in getting ready for homecoming. Primer. Going to want to use a primer for sure, because this is going to keep your makeup on all night as you're dancing and having fun. It's gonna get hot and your makeup's gonna slide right off. So we definitely want to start out with a primer. Primer I'm using today is Maybelline Master Prime, and this is the Blur and Illuminate one. They have like two other ones. One's a blue one and one's like a green one. But I really like this one because it gives me a slight like illuminating glow, but it also does keep my makeup on. Okay, so now we're going to go in with a little bit of concealer, and I know this is weird, I never do concealer before I do foundation, but because I want to go for like a full coverage, flawless look today, I'm going to start out with concealing any blemishes that I have, like this guy right here, and this guy right here, and any redness or under eye circles that I may have. To do that, I'm going to be taking my Master Conceal by Maybelline, and this is in the shade Light. So this stuff you need like the teeniest little amount of, and I accidentally used a little bit too much on this one up here, but I'm just going to spread it around my face. Alrighty, so now we are concealed, and as you can see, you can't see this up here anymore, and my under eye circles are more concealed. So now I'm going in with Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth Foundation, and this is in the shade Classic Ivory. I'm going to be mixing that with this Flower Beauty About Face Foundation in LF6. This one's a little bit darker, this one's a little bit lighter. This is normally my shade, but it's a little like ashy for me right now because I do have a little bit of a tan, and this one's a little bit darker and more yellow. So I'm going to mix these together to create kind of my perfect match. For homecoming or any sort of formal event, I really, really recommend any of the Fit Me's. There's a matte and poreless one for those of you that have more oily skin or you want a more matte finish. And then there's the dewy and smooth one, which is very, very dewy. And that is me. I love these because they give you such a full coverage, but yet it's not cakey in any way. It just looks like you have new skin. Also, a little bit of this stuff goes a really, really long way. So you have to be careful. And to blend that in, I'm going to be using my e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush. This is my favorite foundation brush of all time. I haven't found a foundation brush that's better than this. You can see when I'm putting this on, I'm pressing into my skin and bouncing. Pressing and bouncing like so. And this is giving me a really nice coverage, as opposed to if I was going to wipe it, it would be very streaky, and also it wouldn't have that much coverage. Make sure you get your ears and down onto your neck. Otherwise, you're gonna look like you're wearing a mask. Also, make sure you get over your lips. Not necessarily to conceal your lips, but to make sure you don't miss any area right here, because otherwise you look like you have a mustache. So now I have my foundation on, and as you can see how dewy and almost oily this looks. I love that. But we are going to be setting it with a powder, so don't worry if it ends up being too dewy for you. You can always set it with a powder. We will be doing that, but first, more concealer. For my like brightening highlighting concealer, I'm going to be using this e.l.f. HD Lifting Concealer. This is in the shade Fair. I really like this concealer because it is surprisingly full coverage and it has a nice natural tint to it. So it's very close to my skin tone, but just like one shade lighter. Whereas my Maybelline Fit Me right now is about two shades lighter. It's a little too white for me. And for homecoming and stuff like that, you don't want to go the whole Kim Kardashian highlight and contour. It's just going to look too unnatural and it's not going to look good in pictures. So you want to go for something that's like one shade lighter. As you can see, I'm only bringing this down slightly. I'm not doing a whole like giant triangle or anything because I don't want anything that dramatic. I'm just applying some to my chin and the rest of my face. To blend this in, I'm going to be using this pointed kabuki brush that I got off of Amazon. These are like the most amazing brushes ever. They are like kind of rivals for like Sigma brushes. They look just like them and they work just like them, except they're like $5 for the entire kit. So I will definitely link these down below. I use them in my tutorials all the time. Whole kit was like $10 or something like that. So even though they're not drugstore brushes, they're drugstore price brushes, if you get what I'm saying. Feeling good on my own without you. Yeah. I honestly love how this concealer and how this foundation work because my face looks so flawless right now. Like, so now we're going to beat and set this face. To set my under eyes, I'm going to be using this pressed powder from e.l.f. and this is in the shade Porcelain, I think. I love this powder. Like, look how pigmented that is. I think I raved about it in another video. But anyways, this stuff is super duper pigmented. And it is just great. It gives you a nice matte yet brightening effect under your eyes. And while it is a face powder, I use it as an under eye powder, just whatever. You could also use the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, which I'm going to be using to set my face. And to do that, I'm going to be using my e.l.f. blush brush. So now to set my face, I'm using Rimmel Stay Matte, and this is in the shade Creamy Natural. It is very light compared to my skin tone, but I don't like setting my face with a skin tone powder because it can make you look orange and too dark. So I always use one a little bit light because I want it to be not super heavy. To do this, I'm using my e.l.f. powder brush. So as you can see, I still have that dewy finish, but it's not as drastic as before. So now I'm going to be moving on to eyes, and the first thing I'm going to do is use a primer, and I'm using the e.l.f. Mineral Primer. You could always just use concealer, but because I have very, very greasy eyelids, I always have to use a primer. Also, this is going to definitely keep your makeup on all night. Trust me, this primer is amazing. I'm just blending that out with the same brush I used for my concealer. Now you can totally leave this just like this and move on to your eyeshadow, but because I have greasy eyelids, like I say in every single video 12 billion times, I have to set my eyes. So you can just use a cream eyeshadow for this, but I really like using the same powder I used for my under eyes because this stuff is so matte and so creamy and so blendable. It just works amazing as a setting powder for the eyes. You guys ever see me use any of these brushes that look like this? They're black with the wood or yellowish wood. I cannot tell you the name of these because I don't know. I always call them my mystery brushes because I don't know where they came from. I got them for Christmas in a giant set, and they are really nice brushes. I think they have things similar at Crown Brush, but I am not positive, so I'm really sorry about that. But these are just the brushes that I have and the brushes I have to use. So the first eyeshadow I am using is this little one from NYX. This is one of the nude matte eyeshadows, and this is in the shade Blame It On Midnight. It's a beautiful transition shade, and I think it looks very similar to Makeup Geek's Peach Smoothie. I'm just taking this on a fluffy brush from the Amazon brush kit, and I'm just going to start to build this color up in my crease. So from some other eyeshadows I'm going to be using are from my Jaclyn Hill Morphe Favorites palette. While this is not a drugstore palette, Morphe eyeshadows and their palettes are extremely well priced. One Morphe eyeshadow is $2.29, That's cheaper than most eyeshadows at the drugstore, and their palettes are about $22, and you get 35 shadows. And my phone just went off, I'm very sorry. So the first shadow I'm going in is this one right here. I don't remember what it's called exactly, but I will look it up. These shadows in the Jaclyn Hill palette are all sold individually. The ones in normal palettes are not, but I will be able to give you the names of these. So I'm going to use this one right here. It's like below these two shimmery ones. Now I'm going to go in with some cooler tone shades, and I'm going to be using the shade right here that's next to the one I just used. And I'm using an e.l.f. blending brush to blend this into my crease. So now I'm going to deepen that up with this color right here, which is again next to the other one I just used, and I'm using an e.l.f. crease brush to put this on my outer corner. So now for the star of the show, I'm going to be using this L'Oreal Infallible shadow. This is in the shade Bronze Taupe. It's an absolutely gorgeous, taupey, bronzy, shimmery color, and these Infallible eyeshadows, while they are $8, they are sold at the drugstore. They are not the cheapest of shadows, but they are absolutely worth it. You can also get similar shadows on ColourPop.com, and they are only $5. So I'm just gonna go in with my finger and apply some more of this. So now I'm just going back in with that same brush as before with no additional product on it and just kind of blending everything together. So now I'm going to be taking this dark gray and this black from my Maybelline Nude Palette and mixing those together on the e.l.f. crease brush. Now I'm just going back in with that same brush and buffing everything out. Now I'm just going back in with this crease brush and getting some black and just very, very, very lightly applying this to the outer corners. Now I'm taking the more domed fluffy brush from the Amazon kit and blending everything out in the crease. So to highlight the middle of the eye, I'm going to take this color from the Morphe palette. I'm just going to apply this to the center of my lid with a brush. I'm going to tightline my eyes up here in the lashes and also just on the very, very, very edge of my eye right here. I'm going to be using this Maybelline Master Drama eyeliner. Now I'm taking this e.l.f. eyeliner brush with a little bit of this NYX shadow on it, and I'm going to put this on my lower lash line. Now I'm going back in with this shade right here. I'm going to blend this into the outer corner of my eye. So for eyeliner, the one that I'm going to use is this Starlux Pro one, and this is $19 and it's not drugstore. However, a great alternative for this is the Jessie's Girl eyeliner pen. I just don't own that. So now I'm going to apply a little bit of mascara, and I'm using this one. Now I have a story about this mascara. It is my favorite mascara of all time, except I can't find it anywhere. I can't find it online. I can't find it in any store. The only place I can find it is Ocean State Job Lot. So I think it's like some discontinued off-brand that I have no idea what it's about. So I'm really sorry I can't give you the name of this mascara. But if I had to choose one that you guys could use, it would be this one. And this is the Maybelline The Rocket Volume Express Mascara. So for my lower lashes, I'm using this one. This is the 3-in-1 mascara from e.l.f. So the reason why I didn't pack on the mascara like I normally do is because I'm going to be using falsies today. They are the Ardell Demi Wispies. These are 120, and I am so excited because these are absolutely gorgeous and they're so natural. If you're going to do lashes for a homecoming or for prom, get these because they are so natural and so beautiful. They look like regular lashes, just a little bit thicker. So you have our falsies on. As you can see, there really isn't much of a difference. You really cannot tell that they're even really there. Now I'm going to highlight the inner corners of my eyes, and I'm just going to take a shade from here, and this is just going to be this whitish shade right here. I'm just going to highlight my inner corner. Now I'm going to fill in my eyebrows, and to do that I am using my NYX eyebrow pencil. And you can totally choose to fill in your eyebrows or not. If you have nice natural eyebrows that don't need to be filled in, perfect. Mine don't really need to, but I like to anyway, so I'm going to. Make sure that you don't go too bold, otherwise that can look kind of crazy. And for eyebrow gel, I'm just going to be using this one from ELF. Okay, so we are going to move on to the rest of our face. So for bronzer slash contour, I'm going to be using this L'Oreal True Match powder in the shade Coco and an e.l.f. complexion brush. I just think this is absolutely like amazing. Like, I love this powder for bronzing, and I just think it looks so natural and so beautiful. Another thing you don't want to do is go too heavy on the contour or bronzer. It's just going to make you look weird and it's not going to be timeless. So just go very light. You can always put more on, you just can't take more off. Seriously, look how natural that looks. Like, absolutely gorgeous. For blush, I'm going to be using Sweet Retreat by e.l.f. Again, an absolutely gorgeous color for really any look. And I'm going to use an e.l.f. Super Brush to do this. For highlighter, of course, I'm going to be using e.l.f.'s Baked Blush in Pinktastic. Again, just the most gorgeous highlighter from the drugstore. I'm just applying this with a small tapered brush. You don't want to go too heavy on the highlight because it'll kind of look like a disco ball and it's not going to be timeless. So just do it for a little bit of a natural glow. Alrighty, now moving on to lips. I want to go nude with an attitude. I'm actually going to be mixing a bunch of lipsticks today. The first one I'm going to be using is Wet n Wild's Bare Doll. Then to add a little bit of a gloss, I'm going to be using Nude Cream from Milani. Then to set everything, I'm going to be using NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Stockholm. If you want to add gloss, you could add, I would suggest adding a clear gloss. I'm going to use this LA Colors one, just because I do want a little bit of a glossy lip. And then of course, one very important step is setting spray. I'm using this NYX Dewy Finish one. They have a matte finish one, and there's also an infallible spray from L'Oreal, except it is very expensive. So I'm gonna use this one because it's only $8. If your homecoming dress is not as fancy as this, maybe you want something a little bit more casual, you can totally tone this down. Use less dark colors, take the falsies away. Just use this eyeshadow and a little bit of this. Just use these two together. It'll make it super natural, but yet still super gorgeous. So that is it for this look, you guys. I hope you guys liked this homecoming slash formal look that I did. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I want to know what you guys are going to wear to homecoming if you're going. So let me know in the comments below. Bye.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Amaya. So today's tutorial.